Hello, welcome to my tutorial for the day. Today I'm doing red panda and the badger marking. So I have my lines. Oh, I'm sorry. There we go. I have my lines. My references. And my list of markings. We're gonna start with red panda. It's a marking that takes a couple different layers. If you don't remember what layers are, reacquaint yourself. They are everything. I'm just gonna hide this adjustments. Okay. So we're gonna reselect our lines from the selection that we saved in the first video. And I'm going to turn off the shading so you can see better. So I'm gonna zoom in, create a new layer, call it Red Panda. I'm gonna sort of rush through these so the video's not too long, but you'll have to do a nicer job when you do it so that it looks better than what I'm gonna do. So the first part about Red Panda is the solid red. So Red Panda has a stripe that goes down from his eye. And then a clean up where you don't want it. It has on its neck some red, but that doesn't show on my lines. You're gonna wanna change your brush to the hardness is at 0 for the next parts. So on the arm, it kinda goes down like this. Oh, it goes up a little higher. And then it goes up and down. And then across the leg. You can change the hardness back up on your pen since it's easier to fill in the spots that way. And then you just fill all of the legs in and the underbelly. It's okay if you go outside the lines, you can always clean it up later. Alright. And then if you'd like, there's a few tools. I don't like this at all. You can make the eraser soft too. There's a few tools to make this blurrier. It's pretty blurry on the original. So I'm just using the blur tool, which is right here, to kind of bring out the blurriness in this. And then on Panda, there's also a tail tip. A red panda, sorry. All right. So for the next part, we're gonna do a new layer and make it 50% opacity. And then zoom out a little bit. We're gonna fill in the whole thing. And And then I'm going to go into where it's white and use my eraser and erase. So it goes along the ears, the nose. Kind of goes up to the bridge of the nose. And then it follows the eyes down like this. The other ear. If you mess up, don't worry. You can just fill it back in with the red. Alright, and then it also has those aren't very good, but that's where those go. And then for the tail, you want to take your eraser again, hardness all the way down, and make the opacity 50. And we're just going to fill in the rest of those stripes. Those aren't very good. My brush is too big. And that's generally how you do Red Panda. Definitely spend a lot more time on it to make it look better. That's just the basics of where the pieces go. You can merge your layers together at this point, and then it's properly transparent. And next we'll do badger, which is very similar. We're going to do two layers for this also. So we'll start by naming our bottom layer badger. Make sure you turn your eraser's opacity back up to 100%. You want to grab your paintbrush. The bottom of Badger's ears is solid colored, but not all of it. So it goes from the top of the head, follows the eyes, and it curves down in front of the mouth. When you start doing this, give yourself a basic shape and then you can erase and add to it to make it what you want it to be. That's pretty similar. Just gonna fill in this leg. Alright, Badger does not have the soft look that Red Panda does when it comes to the solid color. So you can just use a regular paintbrush. On the stomach, though, it does have little fuzzy bits. Alright, and then on the back it starts sort of just above the knee and curves down like that. You can even show that here. Alright, so that's everything for the solid color on Panda. We're going to do a new layer and set it to 50% opacity. Just like Red Panda, we're going to cover the whole thing. It doesn't exist on the face, so then we're going to erase it from the face. Alright. On his neck, you'll use a soft eraser. There's a little tiny... this part. You'd use a soft eraser and just erase. It doesn't show on my adoptables, though. We do need to get the tail. Oops. So I'll use my eraser. The bigger it is, the more blurry it's going to be when you erase. So we're going to have a pretty big eraser. Alright. And then Badger is a little bit... I'm not sure how to describe it. There's a light spot in the middle of its stomach. So we're going to change our eraser is to big with 0% hardness and about 30% opacity. And we're just gonna... I did it twice, a big one and a smaller one in the middle. Let's see how this looks. Looks pretty good. Our transparencies are correct. And that's how you do Red Panda and Badger. Let me know if you have any questions about that. Thanks for watching.